Hi, magic makers. So, I made some Abu Mouse ears for the new Aladdin movie, and unfortunately, some of my footage was not the best, so I apologize, but I wanted to go ahead and share it with you guys, my step-by-step that I did, and hopefully it can help you come up with your own mouse ears. If you saw my live stream, you know that I lost my pattern, so I had a few complications with this tutorial, but I hope it helps, and I hope it's fun. Remember, please like, subscribe, click that notification bell, and share with a friend because I worked hard on this and I hope you enjoy it. So since I lost my original pattern, I remade the ear pattern. I'll put the link at the end of the video and in the description. Here you see I am working on tracing the patterns onto the foam. I use a cutting wheel similar to what they use in quilting and a cutting pad that I actually have from my Cricut. If you notice, I've had a few run-ins on my crafting table, and that's why I use the cutting pad now. I wanted to have the option of a few layers of foam, depending on how stiff the ears needed to be. I didn't end up using all of the foam I actually cut out. I decided to make each side of the ears a different color. I was going for the brown fur on Abu for the front section, and I also use interfacing, which is iron-on, so that it can be attached to the front and back of the fabric to help keep its shape. Of course, I cut one for each ear on the front with the brown fabric, and I checked to make sure it's a little bit bigger than the foam so that I can seam it around the edges. This purple fabric here, it's kind of velvety. I thought this would be good for, kind of in reference to his vest. So I use this for the back of the ears. So I want to lay the front and back with the foam in the middle to make sure that it's sized right and able to be seamed together where it covers up the foam. But I also want to add the fur trim that I got to the edges. This is a little tricky because you have to kind of sew it inside out with the fur tucked inside to get the right look you're looking for. And it's really thick, so you want to use a good needle for this. So I'm not a hand sewer. I prefer to use my sewing machine, and what I'm doing here is pinning the edges together. You want to have the fur actually done where you want it to face inwards the correct way, because you're going to flip these ears inside out after you've sewn them. So I want to have everything settled in place. I probably use more pins than necessary, but I don't like my fabric to move, and the purple was actually a little bit more stretchy than I anticipated, but it really did cover the seams well. You want to leave your bottoms unpinned because they are not going to be sewn. What you're going to do is attach that part to the headband that actually will stay open. And I have all the edges pinned together so that as I sew it, the pieces won't be moving out of place. The hardest part to pin on this is the fur, because the fuzzy part always wants to get in between the fabric, and that part won't actually hold very well, so you want to try to make sure to push that all inside as good as you can. Now that I've got both my ears pinned together, I'm ready to start sewing them. Like I said before, this is pretty thick with the fur in there, so you want to have a good needle so that it won't break on you on accident, and you want to keep that fuzzy part shoved inside the ear as best you can. You want as little of that sewn into the edges as possible. Once you've gone around the full edge, you want to make sure that you haven't missed anything, trim off any excess. And you can see the extra piece I left hanging down. I'm going to go ahead and cut that off right there. You don't have to finish the bottoms because, like I said, they will be attached to your headband. Again, I'm going to go ahead and sew the outside of the other ear and flip it right side out. You can see I missed a spot here, so I have to undo the edge of the seam to make sure that the fur actually gets in there. If it misses the fur in the seam, it won't stay in place, obviously, so you want to keep all your layers together the best you can. I have to admit, one of my best friends in any sewing project is always my handy dandy seam ripper right there. Now I'm checking my ears to make sure that they're both equal in size. I have had to remake a set of ears before because for some reason, every once in a while, they will not be the same size. We insert the foam here and try to see if that needs to be trimmed down in any way to set the shape, and they fit really well. So
now I'm working on the headband. You want to go ahead and cover it with fabric. So I'm making a pattern sized to the shape and width of the headband that I chose. I like the big headbands like this. What I did is I bought one that had fabric already on it. I took the fabric off and it had a little bit of glue still on it, so it made it really hold the fabric in place so I could size it good. And then I'm just going to hot glue the fabric around the top. And then once that's on, don't burn your fingers, you go ahead and tuck it around the edges. I like to do the bottom first because then you don't have a little flap around your ear. And roll it in. Try to smooth it out the best you can. Try it on, make sure the edges are smooth. So I really wanted a mini fez, like the little fez that Abu wears in the movie. I went ahead and just made this pattern right here on the spot as I was filming, and the fleece that I used for the red on it, I wanted a stiff fabric that would hold its shape and hold in place really well. And this worked great. I'm not sure the exact name of it, but it is a very stiff fleece, almost like cardboard stiff. And then for the trim on the edge, I used the purple fleece, which is just basic soft fleece. And it went on really well. And I used a gold trim around the edge as well to add that excess color that he has on his. Now, I hot glued the pieces together real simply, and I thought I'd be able to just hot glue the little fez together. So when I tried to hot glue it together, it just would not stay. So I had to hand sew. And like I said, I'm not a hand sewer. So now the top, I just made a little circle and it stuck really well though. Before you attach your ears to your headband, you want to make sure and go ahead and size, figure out how far apart you want them, where you want them to sit on your head. And so I use a little pencil here to mark the ears themselves so I see the curve of the headband, where I want them to be. And as I put the foam in, I go ahead and hot glue the ears closed. So basically they become a flat surface that's going to go right up against the headband. I don't want to burn my fingers, so I use my pencil here to help shove the ears closed. And I go ahead and put some hot glue and just stick them down onto my headband really well. Obviously, you don't want to burn your fingers, and I have napkins underneath to try to catch the glue from getting on the ears elsewhere. This is the finished result with my little mini fez in the middle. I love the way that they turned out. I think the fez actually really added to the look.
Thank you so much, guys, for watching. I really appreciate your support. And remember,
let it go,
and keep moving forward.
Have a magical day.
Bye.